He's still not much more than a boy, yet we're shoveling expectations of greatness upon him. I wonder, are we doing him a favour? Are we preparing him for his future? Or are we just basking in his light, hoping for a little reflected glory, waiting for the day when we can say, I was there at the start? Mark Viduka is just 18 years old, and for a kid who loves to play soccer, life has become very complicated. Every day he has to distinguish who really wants to help him and who just wants a piece of him.
I mean, I'm only 18 and all these people are ringing me up and wanting me to do this, do that, and go to this shopping centre and coach these little kids and stuff like that, and I thought, just leave me alone.
And this is why they don't want to leave him alone. For in only his first full season in the National Soccer League, Mark Viduka has become the youngest player ever to top the goal-kicking list.
On for Viduka, he's onside, the finish! Mark Viduka, 13th goal in his 13th appearance this season.
And when will Despite missing nine games because of commitments to national junior squads, Viduka scored 16 times. And when he was away, he was even more prolific. Trips to Venezuela and Holland produced 18 goals in just 12 games. The word was out.
That's a great goal!
Mark Viduka is definitely the greatest talent which has come through since I've been there. And I had players like Farina, Krencevic, Eddie Krencevic, the Arnolds, the Ned Zelic. Million-dollar players that come and go, but I think he's a character which... his character will bring him through to being most popular, the most expensive player ever to leave Australia, but also being most probably the best player to leave Australia.
I think experience is the only thing that he really needs because he's got everything else. He's the most, how can I say, complete footballer that I have come across for a very long time. He has everything. He's got balance, he's got poise, he's got skill. I think he's got mental toughness as well, although at 18 he's still got a fair way to go. So I think experience.
Right now, Mark Viduka is experiencing a lot of things. They're calling him a million-dollar man. Talent scouts from Europe have been whispering in his ear, and at home, the phone just hasn't stopped ringing. Then, of course, there's his own Croatian community, pretty much demanding that this year, the Melbourne Knights bring home the National Soccer League title.
The Croatians are pretty demanding. They've always been like that with players and with our team, and I think that's probably why I wanna win this cup more than anything.
His nickname may be the V Bomber, but out here at the Melbourne Knights Soccer Club, he's known as the new grandstand, the new floodlights, and even the new social club extensions. So much hope has been invested in the making of Mark Viduka. It's no surprise that at 18, he's found the weight of that expectation a little hard to bear.
I was thinking, if we lose this one, no one's going to come to watch us next year. And I think it's true because I don't think, knowing the Croatians, that we won't have any crowd next year if we lose it.
Playing for a club like Melbourne Knights, a big club as they are, puts a tremendous amount of pressure on anybody, let alone an 18-year-old. And I think it got the better of Mark at some stage of the season. But I think, you know, overall, he's got to live with it because from now on, if he's to achieve the success that we all expect him to, he's got to be able to cope with it and he'll get a hell of a lot more pressures than what he's getting at the moment.
It's semi-final day, the first leg against South Melbourne at Olympic Park. Mark Viduka knows his club has been to the grand final twice in the last 3 years, only to lose both times on penalty kicks. Today he'll be marked closely. Today, thousands will argue whether he's worth $1 million. The Knights win 2-1, but for Viduka there is little pleasure in the result. He gets few opportunities, there are no goals.
I didn't like that game at all because of the pressure, you know, leading up to it. And I don't know, everything was getting to me. I didn't like that game at all.
It was all getting very complicated,
yeah,
wasn't it?
You it
weren't
was.
Just playing
it,
soccer anymore.
Exactly. It wasn't me, you know, playing soccer. Usually when I play soccer, I love it. I love playing soccer. Lately I've started not liking it.
On a day like this, the boy, Mark Viduka, probably wishes he was 11 again, scoring goals at will, just having fun.
I like playing. I like it, but not as much as I used to like it, you know what I mean? Because I feel that people expect too much from me now, you know? As I said, if I don't score, I'm a failure.
18 and at 18, if you're not enjoying your football, that obviously means there's something wrong. Having spoken to Mark recently on a number of occasions, I can understand why he's not enjoying it, because he's having had to deal with many other things other than soccer. And at this stage, I think he should be left alone and just concentrate on the game and have other off-the-park things handled for him by other people.
And so to the second leg of the semi-final, and an 18-year-old needing to prove to himself that he can cope with this complex problem. If he can't, then the word might spread, a reputation might fade, and a dream might die.
Oh, it was just like a ton off my shoulders. That goal in the first 5 minutes was everything for me, everything.
You always kiss the club emblem?
Always, because, I don't know, I just started this year, I thought, you know, the oldies like it. I mean, the old Croatians, they like it, you know, they're very patriotic and that, and I thought, I'll get in the good books with them. Kiss that.
A few years from now, Mark Viduka may be playing in Italy, and the Melbourne Knights may have their new grandstand. If the dream does come true, it'll be worth asking him if he remembers this goal. I hope he does, for perhaps it was the one which rescued a disillusioned talent and inspired him to explore it further.